और रक्षा मंत्री सीतारमण को सुनते हैं। चलिए सीधे रुख करते हैं लोकसभा का इस वक्त राफेल को लेकर, वो क्या कुछ कह रहे हैं उन्हें सुन लें।
दिस हाउस हु हैव शोन इंटरेस्ट इन द टॉपिक एंड आई वांट टू रिप्लाई देम विद फैक्ट्स एंड इफ फैक्ट्स आर गोइंग टू फाइट इन द कांग्रेस पार्टी एंड दे डोंट वांट मी टू आंसर आई एम सॉरी इट्स वेरी डिसअपॉइंटिंग दैट सीनियर मेंबर्स फ्रॉम द पार्टी इन द ऑपोजिशन मच बिफोर आई कैन इवन स्टार्ट डोंट वांट टू हियर माई रिप्लाई। It's very, very disheartening. It's very disheartening, madam. This country will have to understand that defense purchases are of national security related and therefore very, very important. National security is important whether they are in power or we are in power or any other party is in the ruling in this country.
Yes.
National security demands that all of us, yes, discuss issues, yes, raise questions on issues, but we cannot run away from the facts. We cannot run away from getting the required answers on which rightly in parliament questions have been raised. So thank you very much, madam. I am going to seek your indulgence so that by point, I'm going to have to give reply. Yes. Now let's understand, how is our neighborhood? Our neighborhood for India is well, oh, thank you if you know it. Please have the patience and gracefulness to accept that I have a chance to speak now. Ma'am, please, I would want to tell you, ma'am, the environment around India is very, very volatile. And we've had wars both in the western frontier and in the northern borders. It is important for us to understand, therefore, that India, all of us would want, whoever is in government, would want to have peace in our neighborhood. We'll do everything to keep peace. But it cannot be at the cost of the operational readiness of our armed forces. Yes. It cannot be at the cost of making our armed forces feel that enough is not being given to them to fight. We've had enough number of wars in this neighborhood, and therefore we should recognize that timely getting of equipments for our armed forces should be the priority for any government. Skirmishes or military standoffs keep happening. All of us recognize that these two borders are always highly sensitive, and it is important for us to timely, in time, purchase the required ammunition or the platforms which are required. And in that context, I would want to say, first of all, remembering Sri Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who during in his period started the motion for this 126 MMRCA. It was in his period in 2001, post-Kargil war, that we thought it was important that we should start doing something to give the Air Force enough power, air power. And of course, it was Vajpayee ji who said, and I quote his words, "We can change our friends, but not our neighbors." Let's remember that. Our neighborhood being what it is, we cannot really sit back and watch, nor can we change the neighborhood. And if that's the case, is it not our duty as government, for anybody who's in government, to recognize the sense of urgency with which we have to deal? I would want to give you the picture of how we stand precarious sometimes in decision making, and it is requirement for the leadership to take that call. How was our neighborhood developing in the last 10 years? China added 400 aircrafts between 2004 and 2015. Fourth generation aircrafts, fighter aircrafts like J-10, J-11, J-16, Su-27, Su-30 were all being added to the Chinese arsenal. Even fifth generation stealth fighters were being added. If that's about China, what about Pakistan? They increased their total number of aircrafts by more than double. They had F-16 bought in, and also they added 43 JF-17 class Chinese aircrafts to the arsenal. Now, if this is China and Pakistan, what were we doing in India? In 2002, we had 42 squadrons. In 2007, this came down to 36 squadrons. Further, by the time it was 2015, it was reduced to 33 squadrons. Our neighbors are increasing their capacity, and we, who should have supplied the Air Force with enough power, the motion having commenced in 2001 under Atal Bihari Vajpayee, kept moving at snail's pace, and we did not have, even by 2014, did not have what was moved by Atal Bihari Vajpayee. A deadlock situation was created, and we were left with no additional aircrafts, and we are constantly being reminded there was a deal. We gave this much money. Where was the 126 aircraft? Where were they? Have they got it? What price did they pay? What is this 526 crore that they're constantly talking about? I'll come to that. 2001, NDA gave in principle agreement or approval for the procurement of 126 MMRCA. And the user requirements were also issued, which is called the Services Qualitative Requirement, SQRs, about which Manishri Rahul Gandhiji referred in 2006. These SQRs were issued in 2006. The deal only reached a deadlock in 2014. From 6 when the SQRs were issued, and in 14, you leave the government without anything bought. The sense of urgency, the neighborhood. I'm being reminded that we don't need to talk about the neighborhood. All of us know about it. Oh, all of us knew about it. Did you do something about it? Did you do something about it? Did you get the aircrafts? 2006, the SQRs were released. And in 14, even further, I'll go even further, ma'am. Please, the reasons for the deadlock, even then, were not clear. What was the deal? They were negotiating for 18 aircrafts to be bought in a flyaway condition, and the rest were not to be produced with, let us say, the HAL. The sense of urgency made you think that you should get 18 in flyaway condition. National security is important. I would have presumed that's the reason they went for 18 flyaway. And the rest 108 to be produced in India over 11-year period in their agreement. I want to know if the national security and the sense of urgency, which again, Sri Rahul Gandhi reminded us, when the SQRs were issued, there was a sense of urgency which was also mentioned. Till today, you have not bought aircraft. Was a very emotionally charged member asking. Very legitimate question, I agree. But 18 flyaway you couldn't obtain. By the time it was 2014, after 2006, you went away without even getting the 18 flyaway. I want to know why. Why there wasn't an agreement, there wasn't a deal, you didn't buy any, and today you get up to say, what is the sense of urgency that you have appreciated to get the aircrafts, please? All right? Then, I'm coming point by point, ma'am. Let them have the patience to hear it. Then, the question I want to ask here, yes, I'm answering that. Madam,
don't reach out to them.
There is a minimum period, ma'am. Madam Speaker.
आज क्या हो गया? आज क्या हो गया? नहीं कुछ नहीं बैठिए. आज क्या हो गया? ये क्या हो रहा है? बैठो ना आपसे नहीं है चीज.
Madam Speaker, there is a minimum period required for the production of any such complex platforms.
Just now she has
The assumption that these fighters.
Abhi to shuru kiya hai. Please baithiye. Kya ho raha hai? No, this is not happening. Nothing will go on record. Only minister statement. Yes, madam, you go ahead.
There is a minimum period required for the production of any complex platforms. The assumption assumption that these fighters, the assumption
ये हंगामे में बात कर रही है। I can't help it.
The assumption that these fighters are available off the shelf is really mistaken. None of this is available off the shelf. The IGA was signed.
आपको भी बताना चाहूंगी, मैं आपको भी बताना चाहूंगी, बहुत देर तक सबका डिस्कशन हुआ है। अरे आप थोड़ा सा रखना नहीं, यू विल हैव टू लिसन डिफेंस मिनिस्टर, आप पूरा करने दीजिए, पूरा देखिए तो सही, ये तरीके नहीं होते हैं बीच बीच में टोकने के। शी इज टेलिंग एवरीथिंग, नो यू विल हैव टू, हर समय कोई ना कोई मिसलेड करता रहता है, प्लीज नो, ये तरीका नहीं है। जब मैं कुछ बोल रही हूँ तो मुझसे चर्चा करने का, नथिंग विल गो ऑन रिकॉर्ड लाइक दिस, प्लीज।
IGA, the intergovernmental agreement was signed on 23rd September 2016 and the first aircraft will be delivered in 3 years from that date and the last aircraft will come in 2022. The first aircraft will be delivered in 3 years from 2016. That is in 2019. This year, September, you will have the first aircraft and the 36th aircraft will be here in 2022. Even in the MMRCA, even in the 126 MMRCA proposal, the first aircraft was to be delivered in 3 years from the date of signature of contract. Even in the MMRCA, that was a condition. In the IGA, considering the necessity of an early procurement, the process of negotiation were completed in 14 months' time. The process of negotiation did not run for 10 years, madam. The process of negotiation did not run for 10 years. We finished it in 14 months.
Yes.
And the delivery of the 36th aircraft will be here within. The 36th aircraft has been advanced by 5 months. It has been advanced by 5 months as compared to the MMRCA proposal. Now, I also want to say, ma'am, if this is the way facts are frightening them, let me tell you, there are more facts which can frighten them even more. They have to have the patience to hear us now. Then I would want to ask one question, madam, here, which I'm sure is going to make them shout even more, but I would like to request them to hear the facts. The then RM said to the media, where is the money? The then RM said in the media on 6th February 2014, the then RM said, we can't buy, where is the money? He said it outside of parliament. I want to ask. I want to ask madam, the RM then said outside of this parliament premises, where is the money? I want to ask, what money? Which money, madam? I want to ask, which money? Probably the deal money. I want to ask, madam, because the Raksha Mantri or the Mantralay prepares a detailed schedule even as the contract negotiating committees go about negotiating finer details as to how the payment should be made once the agreement is signed. assume agreement is signed today, and I use the word T0 for that. 2 days ago, this agreement is signed today, we use the expression time zero. We start from now. The planning in the ministry, the planning in the ministry is done in such a way that when T0, that is when you sign the agreement, you have not signed it already. But when you sign the agreement at T0, you have to pay 15% advance. Then T0 say plus 6 months. T0 plus 6 months, you have to pay another something. T0 plus 8 months, you have to do. So the point that I want to tell here is the timeline for the payment, the quantum of payment, the percentage of the total cost of the payment for the aircraft, separately for the weapon system, are all well prepared and kept in the ministry. You cannot come at that time when you're saying, Madam, interestingly, we are also repeatedly told and reminded, you know, the company CEO said 95% the deal was all through, only 5%. We couldn't complete that 5%. On all that is reminded to us, saying we were almost at the verge of completing the agreement, which means they knew also the payment schedules. They also have made a provision in the ministry for it. And in February 2014, how did the Raksha Mantri come out to say, where is the money? Which money is he talking about? Which money is he talking about? So they did not intend buying the aircraft till something else was done. Madam, let me tell you here one thing. There is a difference between defense dealings and dealing in defense. We don't do defense dealings. We deal with defense with national security as a priority. Now again, go back to the process and procedure. 2011, if everything was complete and they were going to finalize the deal in 126 MMRCA, let me tell this. The commercial bid was opened, madam. Commercial bid was opened. And then, this is 126 MMRCA story that I'm telling you, finally, which did not get into an agreement stage. The non-deal, huh? 2011, the commercial bid for 126, which started in 2001, 10 years later, was opened. L1, Dassault Aviation became the L1. And the then RM directed, in fact, let me tell you this, directed independent monitors to examine this issue as to how L1 emerged like this. He asked an independent set of monitors to check up as to why L1 was whoever. Okay, Jay? And then, the reason stated for appointing independent monitors, and I quote here, he said, in the context of the letters received and issues raised related to the L1 vendor, let there be an independent monitor who will go into this to check up if everything is all right. All right, madam? After that, look at the fate. That's what? Look, plane kab aayega? Iska charitra main bol rahi hu. Plane nahi aaya unke zamane mein. Independent monitor. Hamare zamane mein is September mein pahunch rahe ji. Aap intezaar kariye. Independent monitors, madam. Independent monitor who was appointed by the Raksha Mantri then cleared the process. The independent monitor appointed by the Raksha Mantri to look into how the L1 was emerging like that cleared the process. Independent monitor cleared it. Then in June 2012, Even after the independent monitor clearing the process, they did not buy it. Even after the independent monitor clearing the process, they did not buy it. Why? Why? There was a reason. There is a reason. Madam, I'll read this for you. Even after the independent monitors cleared it, he said, and I quote here, the commercial negotiation by the contract negotiating committee, CNC, may proceed to complete its deliberation. Exactly the point which former Raksha Mantri, current finance minister, yesterday elaborated. I am giving you the exact matter there. He said, while on the one hand you cleared it, on the other you said come for review. FM did say about it. I want to give that quote before you, madam. The commercial negotiation by the contract negotiating committee may proceed to complete its deliberations with the L1 vendor and finalize its report. After the CNC report has been finalized, the entire issue of approach and methodology adopted by the CNC to determine the L1 vendor may be re-examined by the MOD finance and MOD to ascertain that it is reasonable, appropriate, and as per laid down procedure. Yes. At what stage is he saying this? At what stage is he saying it? After the L1 is opened, is this the way a bidding contract happens, madam? Anyone who deals with it, this is a matter of national security. And in this, forgetting the importance of having to buy it in time, this is the kind of kilwad which was going on because something didn't suit them. Something didn't suit them. You just have a commercial bid anywhere. After the bid is opened, will there be any interference? They are now talking about interference from the PMO. This is interference because somebody did not receive something somewhere. Yeah. Yeah. This is the interference. Yeah. This is the interference. Yeah. Yeah. You stopped the deal, forgetting that the Air Force was suffering. Sure. So we should be clear. When you didn't get it, because it didn't suit you. The deal didn't suit you. The deal didn't give you what? Money. My. And when I raise these questions, I raise it because the Congress party now should stand up not to ask questions, but to reply to each one of what I'm asking them. Who was it? Who was it who did not settle with you that you couldn't conclude this deal? You couldn't conclude this deal. National interest was thrown away. National security was not cared for.
Yes.
Madam, I allege, even as I am answering each one of their questions that they have raised, I allege, you're not even hearing, yaar. You're not even hearing because you're scared of facts. Madam, I charge and I allege, as I elaborate these things, I allege they did not even intend buying. They kept the motions going, but they did not intend buying. National security was at risk. It didn't matter to them. Their treasury's security was important. Their treasury's security was important. Now I go to the next one, madam. When the deal could not be concluded, let's go. RV. RV. For every AA, there is an RV. All right? Let's not forget. For every AA, there is an RV. RV. Madam. Madam. Oh, yeah. I forgot. For every AA, I'm sorry, madam. I forgot. For every AA, there's just not an RV, there's a Q also. So, abbreviations to entertain the house may be easy. Abbreviations for the convenience and for the joke, it could be easy for anybody. It's a double-edged sword, it can come back. Madam, let me also say, since now, RV is not damad of Prime Minister, it is the damad of the country. Madam, Q was somebody on whose lap none of us grew, all right? Q is somebody on whose lap somebody else grew. Madam, there were two clearly unresolved issues, madam. There were two unresolved issues as to when this deal was deadlocked. Two unresolved issues. One is, Dassault Aviation could not tie it up with HAL to produce the 108. Listen to the facts. 108 aircrafts were to be manufactured with the transfer of technology, and HAL was to be producing it. They could not come to an agreement. They may say, oh, you deserted HAL. But they did not conclude. There was no agreement signed with HAL. All right. There was no agreement of Dassault with the HAL, and therefore they need not constantly shed crocodile tears for HAL. I'd like to tell them there was no agreement signed. What were the two issues which were unresolved? One was Dassault, when they wanted the 108 aircrafts to be produced in HAL, during the negotiations were told that 2.7 times higher man hours are required by HAL for producing the same Rafale, which, if it was to be produced in France, would have been less expensive, because in India, if you were to produce it, it requires 2.7 times more man hour. That was one thing. Second thing, I'm talking about the 126, which they couldn't conclude. Dassault, non-deal. Dassault also did not stand guarantee for the 108 which were to be produced by HAL. Meaning, one, they needed more man hours. Two, they also did not want to stand, Dassault did not want to stand guarantee for those Rafale which are being produced by HAL in India, which means India would be, end of the day, buying 108 Rafale produced in HAL, and mind you, the consumer who is Indian Air Force will be buying it without a guarantee being issued by the original equipment manufacturer. Therefore, this involved, and rightly, this issue remained unresolved. And therefore, the deal with HAL, about which today you have crocodile tears by the day, particularly by the Congress party,
they did not strike
the deal. They could not settle this matter. But today, they said, standing opposite the chowk in Bengaluru HAL unit, they shed crocodile tears. I want to ask, much before I move to specific question of why they couldn't sort it out, there is an HAL unit in Amethi, led by senior member of parliament who all of us respect, Mallikarjun Kharge ji, along with him, Member of Parliament Rahul Gandhi ji goes to HAL Bengaluru, stands at the chowk opposite HAL and says, square or circle or whatever, stands there to say, Rafale is your right. You should have produced it. Statement there. Very well, you made the statement. But I want to say, श्री मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे जी इज ऑल्सो द मेंबर ऑफ द स्टैंडिंग कमिटी विच एंटर्ड इनटू लुक्ड इनटू वेरियस इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू डिफेंस प्रोडक्शन. I am reading from the Standing Committee's report, Madam. I am quoting from the Standing Committee report, Madam. I am reading from the Standing Committee report, Madam. The committee are disappointed. I am reading from the Standing Committee report. The committee are disappointed to note that even after almost three decades, not 2014, 15, 16, 17, after three decades, the ADA has not been able to develop the indigenous aircraft as per requirement of the IAF to combat potential and serviceability, and opine that not fulfilling of requirements of the users has rendered investment of both time and money in the project so far infructuous. Standing committee quoted the report. HAL. All right. That's one thing. One thing. HAL produces the Tejas. All right? Second. And HAL ka mamla is not new to the government then. In 2013, the same standing committee says for HAL, because they were not able to scale up faster, the number of waivers, the government at that time chose to give waivers for the non-performance of HAL rather than look at improving the performance of HAL. Madam, if you are really worried about that DPSU, which is a public sector undertaking under the Ministry of Defense, you will do everything that it takes to make that up and ready for meeting all challenges. But in 2013, the government then, instead of doing anything to improve that HAL ka halat, has only given them waivers. How many waivers? Not one, not two. ADA obtained from them altogether 53 temporary waivers and concessions. 53 concessions, which means you are accommodating everything that HAL, the weaknesses, the problems, the challenges, none of them you will address, but you will go on giving them waivers and cry crocodile tears now when the government is ours. You did not do anything at that time. I will give you one more, and that is a list which the standing committee has given about the number of extensions that this government, UPA government, has given for HAL. Rather than improving their capacity, rather than investing in them, rather than improving their performance, they go about giving waivers, and this is recorded. You've given this. It is recorded in the standing committee. If you really are caring about HAL, you will improve them. You will invest in them. You will try to talk to experts to make it better. You didn't do any of that. Madam, I want to now tell you, if HAL, I'm repeating this allegation. I'm repeating this allegation, madam. if you really wanted to do something for the HAL during 2005 and 14, you have not done a thing. I'll give you the list of things we have done. Presently, following procurement orders are in the pipeline for the HAL. 83 LCA Tejas fighter ka order worth 50,000 crore. 15 combat helicopter ka order worth 3,000 crore. 200 Kamo helicopter ka order 20,000 crore. 19 Dornier transport aircraft ka order 3,400 crore. Other helicopters 15,000 crore. Aero engines 8,400 crores. All of them put together totals to 1 lakh crores, which we have given for HAL. Who goes and sheds crocodile tears? Madam, further, you talk about Tejas capacity. You talk about Tejas capacity. HAL's capacity. Madam, facts, madam, facts. Facts are frightening them. More facts. More facts. HAL capacity of Tejas production. HAL capacity for Tejas.
तो रक्षा मंत्री निर्मला सीतारमण को आप सुन रहे थे। राफेल को लेकर जिस तरह से पिछले दो दिनों से हंगामा हो रहा है, उसका जवाब यहां पर पेश कर रही थी, सवालों के जवाब दे रही थी निर्मला।